I've an awful feeling about this. You'll be hurt out there. I couldn't handle that.
I'll be careful, I promise. And when I'm flush with coin and set up, I'll send for you. I will.
Caroline, come away! Don't exert yourself!
I can't promise I'll come, Edward. If you leave on this fool's errand, I cannot promise anything.
Don't give up on me, Caroline! Not when I need your faith the most.
Putting some shape to your sentiments?
Just a short letter home. I reckon she's past caring anyway.
Oh, you're a hard heart that should be softer.
Or soft in parts that should be hard.
And how is it you're so keen for his hard parts, Mr. Rackham?
You'd like to know my secrets, would you?
Oh, aye. Give me a small hint, like. Or a large one, if you're an upright gentleman.
Open your hand.
Oh!
Who's shooting?
Might be them ships sliding into port.
Jesus.
Well, I'll be hanged. King George has grown tired of our shenanigans.
Who's the grim fella?
That's Captain Woods Rogers. Not a man I want seeing my face.
We desire a parley with the men who call themselves governors of this island. Charles Vane, Ben Hornigold, and Ed Thatch. Come forth, if you please.
Hear about the king's pardon, I reckon.
What the hell is Hornigold doing?
Lily-livered punk!
What are you men up to?
I am grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold.
I assume your reception would be a troubled one.
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. And it's a fairer shake than I expected to see from any pirate. But I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers. These rascals will show their colors in time.
Calm, Commodore Chamberlain. I have given Captain Hornigold my word that he will be equitable.
I'll do you a little good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer afflicting the new world. The King wants them eradicated, above all else.
Is this the town square?
As close to one as we've ever had.
Incredible. It's no cleaner than a dog's kennel. Captain Hornigold, please call your men.
Rackham, Vane, the governor's come calling. Bring Burgess and Corcoran as well.
Methods, Commodore, and I expect you to honor them to the left.
get a wake on.
Aye, stop. Stop.
It's fast, a lot of you. Make way for the king's emissaries.
Out of the way, you bastards. Go on.
Our only aim here is to treat with the masters of this community. All others are encouraged to go about their usual business.
Go on, move! Go!
Commodore Chamberlain, please see that all merchants, masons, and carpenters are rounded up and brought to view this afternoon. We must see about repairing this fortress.
We should be confiscating weapons, Governor. Sending pirates a clear, strong message that the king's emissaries are not to be trifled with.
I have no wish to stir up animosity here, Commodore. And though well armed, we are outnumbered by a decent margin. Slow persuasion is our best and most efficient weapon.
Twaddle, Governor! We should sink every goddamn ship, not blind
the king's palace. To do otherwise, protect
the Silence, Commodore! I am the goddamn governor here, serving at the king's pleasure, and I will make the bloody decisions. Is that clear, sir?
Aye, sir. Your wishes are clear as crystal.
These are the charts, Commodore. We're in position.
Governor Rogers believes he can make men of these monkeys yet. I do not. Return to your post and await my orders.
Pirates shall on or before the 5th of September, in the year of our Lord 1718, surrender him or themselves to any one of the principal secretaries of state in Great Britain or Ireland, or to any governor or deputy governor of any of our plantations beyond the sea, every such pirate and pirate so surrendering him or themselves, as aforesaid, shall have our gracious pardon. Of and for such his or their piracy or piracies. By him or them committed before the 5th of January next ensuing. And we do hereby strictly charge and command all our admirals, captains, and other officers at sea. And all our governors
and commanders of any forts, castles, or other places in our plantations, and all our officers, civil and military, to seize and take such of the pirates who shall refuse or neglect to surrender themselves accordingly.
Stop there.
I pray you take the prudent course, gentlemen, and accept the king's pardon as soon as your hearts allow. For until such time, all of you will be confined in Nassau. I am sorry for this, but in lieu of a public trial, this pardon is your best bet.
The governor puts it far too brightly, maggots. Take this message home. Accept the king's protection forthwith, or we will raise this town to its foundation and stretch your bloody necks.
Peace, Commodore Chamberlain. We are messengers, not executioners. Not yet.
Oh, thank you, sir. God save you.
Look on this as a stroke of fortune, lads. We should take the king's pardon and salvage what dignity we
please
own.
I'll be hanged before I surrender to that bobby.
Check your head, Vane. We had here a rare opportunity, a chance to take something base and shape it into a government made and maintained by men of vision. But in 2 years, we pissed it away. I won't make that mistake again.
It's truth he's telling, and you whelps can't handle it. But you fo'c'sle-headed fuddlers, see you at the gallows.
You'll all be dead men! Bastards!
I need a drink.